Hello and welcome, and thank you for joining us. We're here in Chengdu at the Jianyang Culture and Sports Center Natatorium here in Western China, and the first of the diving competitions at the 31st edition of the FISU World University Games. Men's 3-meter synchro springboard final. And that brings together, of course, teams of two. They're going to be producing some aerial exploits of the highest order. Lou Massenberg and Alexander Lube of Germany. Shuta Yamada and Ryo Nishida of Japan. Also a pair that have got lots of expertise. Bowen Huang and Chao Hui Liang. They also have lots of experience. And junior world silver medal in Kiev for Dongmin and Kang Menhyuk of Korea Republic, Tornike Onikashvili and Sandro Melikidze of Georgia. You can see they have decided not to take part. The American duo Luke Forrester, Samuel Bennett, João Margiotto Dias and Rafael Silva Max de Almeida of Brazil. Now we start off with Lou Massenberg and Alexander Lou. A back 1.5 somersault in the pike position with a DD of 2. Let's see how they get on. Synchronization looks pretty slick to me. And the entry was good. We'll see them come up. You can see that the synchronization and then the entry going in. Nice movement, nice synergy between the two German divers. And they start with 49.8 execution. Very good. And of course, that's synchronization also. Looking very slick. Shuta Yamada and Ryo Nishida. They start off with a back 1.5, back half somersault in pike position, a DD of 2. Again, minimal splash. And you know, you can see that they really are, they've been working well together for a few years. Well, the cheer is unfortunately not for Shuta and Ryo. Who pick up a score of 45 points, and, which is a solid start, of course. It is, of course, for the Chinese duo who are about to show us what they're capable of doing. I was watching them this morning, getting in some training, and yesterday, and they're looking very, very good indeed. Huang Boen Liang Chao Hui of China. Yeah, you can just see that that there is great complicity between the two divers. They have been competing with each other for a couple of years now, and you can see that, of course, when you see that they register a tally of 52.2 with a degree of difficulty down at 2, of course. It just means that synchronization needs to be top quality. Next up, Korea Republic's Dongmin Jung and Kang Min-hyuk. Again, I like that. I think that you know, they really have been working hard to just get themselves completely diving as one. It's not easy at all, of course. You know, you have to go through a whole routine. You have to go through hours and hours of preparation, and you can see that the appreciation from the coaching staff from Korea Republic obviously means a lot. 47.4. Next up, the Georgian duo of Tornike Onikashvili, Sandro Melikidze. It's a back half somersault pipe, same as we saw previously. Nicely done as well. Very strong divers, these two. Again, two divers who have been, who know each other inside and out. I think that when you see what they've been doing recently with them, with winning silver in the diving GP, 46.8, and also Fukuoka, competing well. Dias Mariotto and Silva Max de Almeida, Brazilian duo. And that was absolutely fine indeed. And again, you can understand the applause. Very slick. Now that's a good score, 45 for the Brazilian duo. We go back to the top with Lou Massenberg and Alex Luba. And they have chosen 3.1 DD. It's a forward 3.5 rotation, pike position. Big dive, big points, and a bit of pressure. Well, that was not bad at all. And the judges will like that. And because look at the synchronization. Every move until the final, where just as they're coming out, maybe the moment where they might have lost a bit on synchronization. But execution-wise, I thought that was really, really good. And 75.33 because of the DD. And that is a big score. And now we're starting to enter the big boys category in terms of big points and big dives. So now it's time to shine. Shuta Yamada, Ryo Nishida of Japan. And now they're going for the back 2.5 rotations, pike position, 3 in the DD. That was well executed as well. And fans, teammates, giving them plenty of credit. Let's just have a look at the replay. Well, the synchronization was off. Execution not bad. You can see that he's already going around and completing his first rotation. Nishida before Yamada was there. 58.5. So there's lots of work to be done. And now, of course, we have Huang Bowen Liang Chiaohui, inward 3.5, and the tuck 3.4. This is a massive dive for a very large tally of points if it's well executed. Yeah, they'll get a lot of appreciation from the home fans here in Chengdu. But I'm just looking at that. And the synchronization, a little bit off. They would have probably got more than 75, maybe 80. But on this occasion, losing a few points. It's still a big score, of course, because of the DD. It's a difficult dive to complete. But 70 points is not bad at all, 70.38. And they're in second position with the German duo topping the bill. Dong Minjong, Minhyuk Yang of Korea Republic, 3.1. It's a forward 3.5 pike. Well, that was pretty impressive from the judges' side. I'm just wondering how they got on with the synchronization. Just veering off to the left marginally there. If it's not spotted too much, just from that side view with the judges just straight down that line there, they might be okay. And 67.89 is a good score for that dive. And pretty well balanced out with the execution and synchronization. Toniko Nakashvili, Sandro Melikidze, the Georgian duo. It's a DD of 3. It's an inward 2.5 rotations. Well, that was beautiful. That really was. I think that that's going to be a good, solid score. When you look at the 3 DD, and just look at the way, the power that they get, both of them together. Synchronization was there. Maybe a little bit off. But it's still 64.8 points. That's a good score. They just look at themselves thinking, well, there's still a bit of work to do. They're still tucked in third position there. This is now the Brazilian duo, João Margiotto Dias and Fel Silva Max de Almeida. It's back 2.5, pike 3, currently 6th. Looking for that graceful rotation in the air. Started off quite well. And the entrance wasn't too bad at all. Looking at a good 55, 54, 50, 55 points, I think. The entry wasn't good, though. That's where they lost out. Yeah, just falling back a bit. You can just see when the legs are going over the top, that obviously means that just overcooked your dive. And there we are after round three. And it's the German duo of Massenberg and Lube at the top. Huang and Liang just 2 points behind, with only Kashvili and Melikidze of Georgia in third place. We go back to the top, the leaders. Can they back themselves up with this? Now, what a dive this is. This is not a small dive. Reverse 1.5 rotations, 3.5 twists, 3.5 DD. Massive dive here. Well, that was fantastic. That really was. Oh, the synchronization, just a little bit off. And a little bit of splash, just coming over a little bit, so they'll just lose a few points there. Still gonna be a big score. I was very impressed. I thought that was a really good dive. You just see that there, maybe it's just a little bit too, just pushing a little bit too much coming out of the final twist. And obviously with the head not going up, as his coach was explaining. But still, 75 points, still in top position, 247. Next up, we have Nishida Yamada. This is forward 3.5 rotations pike, so 3.1. If they can get 60 points for this, they're in a pretty good place. Well, they'll lose points just individually. See that Minhyuk, just with a few issues there, just one entry coming out, battling to get his body vertical for the point of entry. Will be a little bit peeved with himself. The Japanese contingent will give them the support, but 55.8, so he's missing out on a few points there. And then, of course, we go straight to the top, and this is what it's all about. These are the guys who are looking to try and get themselves into the top spot. Reverse 3.5 somersault, tuck position 3.5. Well, again, you can see that the synchronization was lacking there. Just not finding the right groove, the right synergy between the two. It's a massive jump, so you have to go high. And you can see that obviously they're just not very much aligned when they're coming back down, or even when they're going back up. You can see that 68.25 could have been a 75 pointer, but still in terms of execution, it was, well, perfectly executed. 68.25 for the Chinese duo. Moving to second place, it's a forward 2.5 with a twist for Zhong Kang, DD of 3, currently in fifth. Well, all credit, and they might come back with a pretty solid score there. We'll just take a look at how they managed to maneuver in the air. 63.9. Synchronization lacking, the execution was good. And here's Onokashvili and Melikidze, round four. Effort here. It's a forward 3.5 pike, 3.1. This is the pair who are looking very good, looking very composed so far. And honestly, I think they're going to get a good score again. This is just perfectly poised for the Georgian pair to get themselves on the podium, because that is, again, good synchronization. Point of entry was good, so the execution was well. Look how they're just really tight around the thighs, and just make sure that they're just squeezing really hard. Look at that, 69.75, and that keeps them in third position. So after round four, Massenberg and Lube, 7 points above Huang and Liang, with Onikashvili and Milikid sitting third ahead of Zhuang and Kang, Korea Republic, Japanese pair down there in fourth. Now looking at the two final dives. Two final dives will determine who will be taking a medal home. Inward 2.5. Pike position. And again, they just managed to do the business here. And it's less complicated than some of the dives that we saw in the last round. But you can see they really do work well together. This is a pairing who have obviously spent hours and hours on the springboard and just showing us what they're capable of doing. And they'll pick up a big score there of 68.4 with a difficulty of 3. Now, it is time for the Chinese duo. Forward 4.5 somersaults. The tuck position 3.8. I mean, we talk about how big this is. This is absolutely massive. Let's see what they can do here. This is a massive dive for a large tally of points. Didn't get it right last time. Well, the fans think that there's a big score there to come. They will need to try and get a, well, if they get 76.05 points, they move up into the top position, and they do with that. It's just the difficulty of that dive has basically given them a big score. They're very happy with that. And you can see it's the difficulty 3.8 that just lands them a big tally of 79.8. They move to the top, just 3 points above the German duo. And into gold medal position. Next up, forward 2.5, two twists, 3.4 DD for Zhuang and Kang of Korea Republic. Well, the synchronization was off. The execution was good. And as I said, sometimes when you actually got the eye line of where the judges are positioned, well, you're going to see that the synchronization tally will be down, but the execution will be good. .67.32. And that's enough to push them up to third position. The Georgian duo, currently third, coming into this dive. And they've chosen a forward 2.5 with a twist and a pike position. Another relatively tame dive, if I can say that. Still complicated though. Oh, that's a really good entry, really good dive. And again, the consistency. They are, the Georgian, he's so focused on what his boys have been doing that the Georgian coach obviously, you know, just having a little bit of a meet and greet with one of the staff. And 57.6, so they will drop down to third. No, they're still in the third position, sorry. And after round five, with one round to go, you can see that the Chinese pair of Huang Boen and Liang Chaohui topping the table. But look at this for a tussle going into this next dive. Massive for Lou Massenburg and Alexandre Lube. Massenburg at the University of Applied Sciences in Berlin. And Lube and the Ruth Aachen University. And this is all about getting a big score. Forward 2.5 with two twists. Pike position, 3.4. This is for a gold medal if they can get 75, 80 points. Well, that is very well executed. And they will get a big, big score there, I think. If they can get themselves up to 75, 80, then they will be pushing the Chinese duo right to the wire because, well, it's who's going to get the gold between the two. 73.44. Very fine work there by the German duo. But it does, it's going to be tough, but it's definitely possible. That's all they can do. A tally of 389. 69.69 points. to win gold medal. It's a forward 2.5, somersault, 2 twist pike, 3.4, big dive. Well, that's not bad at all. And surely they're going to be pushing the German duo all the way. Can they get 70 points, more than 69.69? Yes, they have. Yes, they have. Execution was very good. Synchronization a little bit down. There was a big degree of difficulty. But look at the score, 77.52. And that puts them in the top position with 397.35. And that logically is, well, how it's gonna finish. But we still have a couple of pairs to go. Hyung Dong Min, Kang Min Hyuk. This is an inward 2.5, pike position 3. Point of entry, lacking a little bit. Would have preferred a little bit better synchronization. And 63 points. Pushes them up into third position. And they will be happy with that. Now, we move down to the Georgian duo. Toniko Nakashvili, Sandra Melikidze, looking for that bronze medal. It's a forward 2.5 somersault, 2 twists, 3.4. Well, that's is it enough? The question is it enough? Lacking a little bit in the synchronization. And because of that, I think they might have just lost out on their mill, 62.2. Well, they've moved back into third position. That's a really, really good. They've saved it, 343.17. Big hugs all round, and they will walk away with a medal. That's a fantastic achievement for the Georgian duo. The first medalist, the first diving discipline of the week, and it goes to Bowen Huang and Chahui Liang of the People's Republic of China. Germany's Lou Massenberg and Alexandra Lube pick up silver, while Georgia get themselves the third place on the podium. Tornike Onikashvili and Sandro Melikidze to wrap up the first event and the first medal ceremony of this week's events.